So I spent the last 5 years of my life making games with Unity, and I gotta say I'm quite proud of how far I've come since the beginning. This is my entire game dev journey from a complete beginner to an absolute Unity god in just 13 minutes. Starting all the way back with my first ever Unity game. 2019. My second year of university studying computer science, and I was already starting to reconsider my life choices. But then a friend of mine told me about this cool exchange program from Finland called Oulu Game Lab. The only problem was that in order to be accepted, I needed to pass the interview. And just like any other mere mortal trying to get into game development, I discovered our lord and savior, Baddies. So I copied, followed Baddies tutorials, and 2 weeks later my first game was done. Well, here it is, let's open the project and... my eyes! I totally forgot that Unity didn't have a dark theme back then. Actually it did, but you had to pay for Unity Pro, so yeah, I'm not gonna do that. So the game is more of a proof of concept than an actual game. You can jump around and collect strawberries. There used to be a basic enemy that you could jump on, but I guess he's gone. The level was supposed to be much bigger and have an actual ending, but my editor crashed while working on it. And of course I didn't save, so... D tier. I think that's fair. But hey, at least there was enough for me to get accepted at Game Lab. So, Finland, here we come. Actually, I lied to you. That wasn't my first ever Unity game. A few days ago, I discovered this ancient relic of the past. A USB drive containing my actual first ever Unity game, dating all the way back to 2017. I was still in high school back then. And of course, being so young and naive, I said I would make a game using Unity. It was supposed to be an idle game, like Cookie Clicker, but instead of cookies, you'd have to earn money by buying some shady underground businesses. You know, like hiring beggars for money, employing car theft specialists, or bank robbers. I know it sounds very cringe, but I was only 17 at the time, and I think I broke it? Anyway, this thing is barely playable, so... F tier. Okay, back to... where was I? Oh yeah, Finland! Best known for its extremely friendly weather, very outgoing people, what the f*** is this? And... the way Game Lab worked was that we would have to pitch our game ideas and the best ones would proceed to the development stage. I tried really hard, but all my ideas were no good. But then on the last day, I finally got it. So I spent the entire night trying to create a basic prototype and recording some gameplay. Then the pitching time came and I was like, so you're gonna be this penguin trying to run from global warming and you're going to move ice pieces in order to create a path for him. And to my surprise, the judges were like, hey man, I really like your idea. And it looks like you even got pathfinding to work. Yeah, pathfinding. It was definitely not me controlling the player with WASD in that recording. And it worked like a charm because my game was greenlit to continue its development. So it turns out this place is right next to Fingersoft, aka the guys who made this tiny little game called Hill Climb Racing. The best part was that we were able to test our games with actual players. They would promote our games inside Hill Climb Racing to other players from countries such as India, and we could use Unity Analytics to measure certain metrics. But enough with that, here's the actual game. You advance by creating a path using Tetris-shaped ice pieces. Once you step on ice, it starts to melt, and if you fall in water, it's game over. But don't penguins know how to swim? Whatever, it's just a dumb game. Fish is the main currency that you have to collect in order to upgrade your penguin or unlock new characters. Wait a minute. You collect fish. Fish stays on land. Okay, so aside from these small oversights, it was actually a pretty big game as it has over 80 levels. You can still find it on Google Play, but please don't buy any of the in-app purchases. I can't even access my AdMob account anymore. B tier. The game could really use a remake. So after that, Game Lab ended and we all went to a karaoke bar. But don't worry, cause it was soon time for the Global Game Jam. This is my first ever game jam and I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing. Sure, I've made a few games by now, but I never made a game in such a short amount of time. The theme of the game jam was repair, so we were gonna make a 2D endless side-scroller where you fly a ship in the sky that is constantly taking damage. Your goal is to survive for as long as possible by not getting hit and by collecting those repair hot air balloons. There's also a dragon boss that appears after some time, and the game has an upgrade system for your ship. For my first game jam, I think it turned out way better than I could have ever imagined. If you find any bugs, it's probably on me since I was the only programmer in the team, and I barely slept at all during those 48 hours. But hey, at least there was free pizza, right? Now tell me, who the hell puts pineapple and mayo on pizza? That shit's nasty! Anyway, the game goes to C tier. In the meantime, I've also applied for an internship at this Finnish game dev company, and looks like I'm gonna be starting next month. By this point, I've been in Finland for over 6 months, and I was starting to get used to the harsh conditions. But there was one thing that I would never get used to: the polar night. I mean, this town is located in the middle of nowhere next to the fucking Arctic Circle. Of course everyone is bound to get depression at some point. But they say Finland is the happiest country in the world. I actually asked some Finns about this. Wanna know why? Because all the sad people have already killed themselves. Whoa, that actually got really dark. Forget I said that. So the game I'll be working on for this company is an incremental game, also known as an idle game or a clicker game. This one is mostly inspired by another mobile game called Idle Miner Tycoon. This is Master of Mines, or MOM for short. So I guess the game doesn't need much explanation. You simply press this button to force those poor and miserable dwarves to work, and you use that money to buy even more dwarves. You know what? Making idle games is way harder than it looks. And that's because you need a way to work with those huge numbers. How are you gonna store a number like 46 novim decillion? That's 46 followed by 60 zeros! I spent so much time trying to write my own class that could store incredibly large numbers, only to bang my head against the wall whenever I would end up with a number that's 10 times bigger than it was supposed to. Just use a double, you'll thank me later. Overall, the game was decent, for an idle game at least. I'd say it goes on C tier. After that, I was assigned to work on another game. Do you know the game Ni no Kuni 2? Yeah, don't worry, I didn't get to work on Ni no Kuni 2. But do you know the RTS-style skirmish minigame where you control multiple squads? This next game was basically that, but as a mobile game. You need to position your troops so you're always facing the enemies they counter and avoid the enemies they get countered by. It's a simple rock-paper-scissors mechanic. We actually managed to get a fully playable scenario, and the development was going quite well. Except for the fact that this game was a ticking time bomb that would absolutely melt your phone. If you ever want to make a 3D mobile game, you better cap your FPS at 30. While smartphones sure are capable of running it at 60 FPS or more, they will start overheating like crazy. And in about 30 minutes or so, your performance will go and your phone battery will go. Well, aside from those small optimization issues, things were going great. But shit was about to hit the fan, because guess what time it is? It's 2020!
Death toll now has risen above that of the SARS outbreak.
We now have a name for the disease, COVID-19.
To make it all worse, my exchange program is about to end in like a month or two, and I can't even return to my own country because the entire world is on lockdown. So I stayed in Finland and continued my internship from home. But things were starting to get more depressing each day. I was starting to feel very lonely, and I was having difficulties falling asleep. And just like that, the development also took a hit. However, one day we decided to throw a grill party with all the members from GameLab, because this was Finland after all. After that, I finished the game and I think it had potential and could have turned out way better. I'd say it's a B. Forget it, it's a C. After I returned to my home country, I joined another game jam, only to end up with probably the worst game I've ever made. This was supposed to be a game about a lion who would always worry about possible dangers lurking in his house. You know, like forgetting to turn off the stove or hackers stealing his Instaroro account. The concept was really good, but it was the execution that killed the game. The movement is basically a moonwalk simulator. There are all sorts of problems with layers and collisions. And then there's this. So it's gotta be D tier. After that, I experimented a bit with terrain generation using marching cubes, an algorithm for generating 3D meshes. I wanted to make a voxel-based terrain similar to the one in 7 Days to Die. So I said, hey, that's great and all, but you know what would make this even better? Porting it to VR, duh. So what better way to get into VR than playing Beat Saber all day? I mean, making a VR game, yeah, that's what I meant to say. The Oculus Quest was really cool, but for developing games, I gotta say, this is the biggest piece of shit I've ever seen. Why do I need a smartphone app to turn on developer mode? You want to connect this thing to your computer? Well, of course, you need to get this Oculus app for desktop. You want to install an APK file? Yeah, good luck, you'll need another app called SideQuest, because for some reason, the Oculus won't let you install an APK that's already there. It's right f***ing there. Why do I need so many f***ing apps? I'm done with this. Oculus Quest experience goes to F tier. After that, me and two other friends decided that we were going to make our most ambitious game yet. Of course, I'm talking about the hack and slash game. This game is the perfect definition of don't start working on big games if you don't know what you are doing. It was supposed to be an RPG type of game. You'd play as this girl in a fantasy world with the ability to travel between dimensions using portals. You'd also have your own base on this island where you'd supposedly build your own little town and bring with you the many NPCs you meet along the way. The plan was to make a polished demo and use it to raise enough funds to eventually finish the game. We worked for about 2 years on this game and I think we ended up with some pretty good combat. Every animation is so complex as it has over 20 animation events, which trigger visual effects, screen shake, animation freeze and so on. Being an indie developer is really hard. Besides making a very good game, you also need to take care of things such as marketing by posting on Twitter. I mean, X. Who the hell calls it X anyway? Going to random game dev conferences, or the worst of all, starting a devlog. Besides the fact that you're already working on a game, you also need to learn how to write and edit videos. And they better be good videos, otherwise forget it. Overall, I think the gameplay turned out to be pretty solid, but this game is definitely far from being complete. I would give it a B rating, but the amount of memes you can make with the characters instantly puts this into S tier. During this time I also joined other game jams, since you know what they say, you gotta alternate things every now and then or something. But this turned out to be one of the most fun games I've ever made. It's a 1v1 PvP game where you must shoot the other player using randomly spawned weapons. Since punishment was the theme of this game jam, we decided to add power-ups. Actually, they are more like power downs. You know, stuff like inverting their control scheme, constantly spawning bombs over their head, or making them move with the speed of an ant. This one is super fun to play, but you will need a friend to play against, since this is local only. And since I don't have any friends, all this gameplay was just me trying to play against myself. I'm gonna put it in B tier. So now we finally arrived to the moment when I started making all those random games for my YouTube channel. I'm gonna go through those quickly since you can watch my other videos. I hope I'm done real soon, cause this script is already 9 pages long. Well, here they are, Circle Survivors. Not made with Unity. Upway Turfers. A really fun clone of Subway Surfers, but in first person. If you haven't done so already, you should really try this, it's really fun to play. A tier. Capybara Tower. This is basically Jump King, but in 3D. The game's really fun, however it can make you throw your keyboard through the monitor because of how incredibly hard it is. I mean, what can I say? The game has capybaras. It's clearly in a league of its own. Okay, I pull up. Dimensional Descent. This is a game I made together with a friend during a 48-hour game jam. It's inspired by Vampire Survivors, but it has a twist. Your projectiles are coming back at you whenever they reach the other side of the screen. The game is really fun to play and might deserve its own video. A tier. 1 minute game. I mean, do I really have to? It's a game made in 1 minute. F tier. 1 hour game. For being made in 1 hour, I think it's pretty decent. It goes into C tier. 1 day game. This is basically the 1 hour game but made in a day. However, the obstacles are now properly mapped to the music. It's basically a proper rhythm game now. I think it's better than the 1 hour version, so B tier. Itinu. Not made with Unity. And lastly we have the 1 week game. It's basically the 1 day game but made in 3D in the span of a week. The game is fine and all, but you guys didn't really watch the video, so I'm gonna downgrade it to C tier. Even after 5 years of learning Unity, there are still many things I have yet to try, like making a multiplayer game. So if you wanna see that, be sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel. This video is already long enough already,